go to work.
But this guy, I'm on the yellow line, but this guy is right behind me and can't get his fuel. I just stepped in to get some breakfast, but let me get out of his way. Pop the red one to make sure that nobody pulled my fifth wheel. They did not. Seatbelt on. I just wanted to do that quickly so I can he can pull ahead and get his fuel. Without me being in his way type thing. Okay. Alright. Turn your head more slow, sir. You're a bit making me dizzy. These tater tots. I remember when I was a kid. I saw them on the, excuse me, oh, a little hot. Ooh, just a moment. My GPS says we're on a through routing for trucks prohibited or not advised. In other words, we're on an illegal route right here, which is funny because it's a truck stop where trucks are supposed to be. And the GPS says, no, you're not supposed to be on this road. Tater tot story. When I was a kid in school, like a young kindergartner, maybe first grade, second grade, in the 70s, I never even heard of, I hate these self-canceling turn signals. Tater tots, never heard of them. I saw them on my tray at cafeteria time, lunchtime. But I never knew. I was afraid to eat them. I'm like, I don't know what that is. I'm not eating that. I don't know, I didn't know it was a potato. I just thought it was weird. And every day, you know, finally, I saw some other kids eating them. I'm like, well, let me try one. Because there would be a small handful on our tray. And I tried it. I was like, oh my God, that is so good. Wow. And then, you know, I told my mom about it. I said, Mom, these things in the store, you know, in the frozen section, tater tots. And she had never heard of them either, I don't think. But she started buying them, and they were easy, and just throw them in the oven, and I don't know if it's 20 minutes or whatever, and we had them every once in a while, and I ate the crap out of those things. Some advanced skills here when you're holding your food and eating and driving is, it may become illegal in the near future. So I want to document it to show the world, oh my God, look at that guy driving with food in his hand. Okay, so I'm in sixth gear making this turn. I was able to do it in sixth gear, which is insane. With food in my hand too, whoa. I may have to hold this video and not post it until I'm retired. Catch a lot of criticism. But I do have hands-free camera. I've had people tell me that if you're recording while you're driving, that's distracted driving. Yeah, but the camera's on my head. It's a body camera. But you're distracted.
I'm what?
Yeah, you're mentally distracted a little bit. It has an effect on your driving. Oh my God, dude. What about all these motorcyclists with head cameras, helmet cameras? They're doing okay. So good. You can see I got two hands on the wheel. So good. Okay. Set my cruise control. see that. That's warning you that it's a little steep bunny hill right here. It's a short one. If I turn the engine brakes on, we're still in high gear, top gear, but with engine brakes, and the speed limit's 75 through here, I'm not worried about it. I'm going 62. We can afford to gain a few miles per hour, and if it tries to get up past 70, I can touch the brakes, which I don't think it will. It's just short little. Look at how bright that sun is this morning. Damn. Oh. Beautiful. You see that in the mirrors? Oh my goodness. So it's November 13th, Sunday, 2016, 8 o'clock in the morning Central Time in New Mexico, I-40, westbound, mile marker 275-ish, Santa Rosa, New Mexico. Beautiful. See, I got it parked on the side. No four ways, four way lights, nothing. Dude, number one, it's a bad deal to park on the side of the interstate unless you're legitimately broken down. A four wheeler can run right into the back of you. See that? That's insane, dude. Look at his butt hanging out. Oh my god. Gross. He's probably got to pull over to use the restroom, but he just passed up three truck stops 4 miles ago. Really? Now, if you have to do that and there's no truck stop around, and you're under such a tight schedule that you got to do it on the side of the road, I'll show you a good place to do that. You get off the off-ramp, get back on the on-ramp, and pull over on the on-ramp side. The reason is, if you pull over on the off-ramp to do their business, people are coming off the freeway at speed and decelerating. Could run into you. However, if you do it on the on-ramp, people that are coming from a slower speed to a faster speed, less likely to run into you. So here we go. Off-ramp right here. I don't know that it rejoins the freeway right here, but it appears that it does right there. So you'll get off and get back on. You're better off to pull over on the on-ramp and do your business. You're like right over there, away from the live traffic. You're one lane away, an extra lane of safety. If somebody were to hit you, run into you, they're coming from a slower speed to do that. Not like a freeway speed. Does that make sense? So you got two layers of safety there, compared to just pulling over right here on the side of the road. Live traffic, and maybe there's two trucks trying to pass each other, snail races, and the guy's going to rip your window mirror off or your door off possibly, or hurt you or smack you or something. It's not good. Not a good idea. Unless you got a flat tire, you can't, no choice. Engine shut down or something.